Do you know what personal pronoun is? Let's know about personal pronoun. I, you, he, she, it, we, they can all replace noun no matter how big or how small nouns are. Whether you are replacing one noun that is singular or many nouns plural. We use them all the time. You can define personal pronoun like this. Personal pronouns are pronouns that are associated primarily with a particular person, first person as I, second person as you, or third person as he, she, it, they. Personal pronouns are of two types, subject personal pronoun and object personal pronoun. Subject personal pronouns are I, you, he, she, it, we, they. Object personal pronouns, me, you, him, her, it, them. Uses of subject personal pronouns. We use subject personal pronouns as subject of the verb. For example, I like your toy. Here I is a personal pronoun acting as a subject of the verb like. You are late. Here you as a personal pronoun acting as a subject of the helping verb are. He is my uncle. He is a personal pronoun acting as a subject of the helping verb is. We live in India. Here we as a personal pronoun acting as a subject of the verb live. They come from Mumbai. Here they as a personal pronoun acting as a subject of the verb come. Use of object personal pronouns. We use object personal pronouns as the object of the verb. For example, can you help me please? Here me is object personal pronoun acting as an object of the verb help. I can see them. Here them is object personal pronoun acting as an object of the verb see. She doesn't like him. Here him is object personal pronoun acting as an object of the verb like. I saw him in town yesterday. Here him is object personal pronoun acting as an object of the verb saw. We saw them in town today, but they did not see us. Here them and us are object personal pronoun acting as objects of the verb saw and see respectively. Sometimes we use object personal pronouns as the object of the verb after preposition. She is waiting for you. In this sentence, we have used you as the object of the verb waiting. It is used after preposition for. I will get it for you. In this sentence, you as the object of the verb get, and it is used after preposition for. Give it to her. In this sentence, her is the object of the verb give, and it is used after preposition to. Why are you looking at him? In this sentence, him is the object of the verb look, and it is used after preposition at. Don't take it from us. Here, us is used as the object of the verb take, and it is used after preposition from. I will speak to them. In this, we have used them as the object of the verb speak, and it is used after preposition to. Look at these sentences carefully. I'll decorate the room. You place the flowers in the vase that you bought yesterday. Here, I, you, and you are pronouns. Match the pronoun to the noun. Use singular pronoun to replace the singular noun. The monkey loves bananas. If you want to replace the word monkey, which is a singular noun, for this we will use the singular pronoun it. So now sentence will become it loves bananas. Use plural pronoun to replace the plural noun. Here bananas are plural nouns. That is why for bananas we need a plural pronoun. Here we will use plural pronoun them. So the sentence will be it loves them. Whenever you use a pronoun, the noun you are replacing should be clear. For example, we took the test in the morning. It was difficult. Here the word it refers to test. Test is an antecedent of the word it. In your writing, we should have a clear antecedent, the noun or pronoun it refers to. Antecedent means noun the pronoun refers to. Thank you.